And the Oscar goes to Dean Semler, Dances with Wolves.
Dean Semler is one of the most graceful people who ever walked the earth. He's a man full of grace.
I've never seen anyone so enthusiastic about work as he is. And he still has the childlike enthusiasm for what it is that he does.
I think he's lost two different tips of two different fingers in shooting and never stopped.
He's gone all over the world, shot mostly outdoors, and how he's able to sort of do that, it speaks to a very, very strong constitution. But I didn't know he'd lost two fingers.
This is Mad Max 2.
The second offering in the Mad Max series, Mad Max 2.
This was the first collaboration between George Miller and Dean, and it's sort of a love story after that. They love each other, you know, they respect each other, and, oh, I almost got tears.
Every film is tough. It's creative warfare. And in amongst all of this, there was Dean, the calm center of the film. And that's when I realized how exceptional he was.
I never for a minute thought, when I was living in 19th Street, Red Bank, that I'd get further than Adelaide even. And to think what I've done in the past now, to where I've been, to every country, to every major city, to some of the greatest, most luxurious hotels in the world, to some of the toughest living conditions. There's been a lot of water under the bridge since that asbestos house in Redbank. One day I received a package, and in it were 20-odd letters written by school children from Renmark in South Australia, my hometown. Dear Mr. Semler, well done on your effort in your career. Our class congratulates you for your hard work being a cameraman. Could you come to our school and introduce yourself? You could also show us how to make videos.
The South Australian Academy Award winner has taken a break from Hollywood to give something back to his hometown. Today, filmmaker Dean Semler taught school students in Renmark a lesson they'll never forget.
Action! Oh! Oh, fantastic! Oh,
through the delicate interplay of light and shadows, you make emotional and physical landscapes come to vivid life. And because of that, artists often do their best work when they're working with him.
Dean seemed to channel something. It comes through him, you know, it's nothing you can learn. You can't be taught this. That's why they called him Wizard of Oz. He really is.